Attention all personnel, attention all personnel. The USDA Forest Service Savannah River will be conducting a prescribed burn today near east of Forest Service's building
around Tower Bridge Road. Approximately 1,417 acres will be burned starting at approximately 1,000 hours and lasting until 1,700 hours. Employees should use caution in this area of the site. Timeout 0803.
Prescribed fire is just one tool that USDA Forest Service Savannah River uses to help manage the natural resources on over 170,000 acres at SRS. Along with the benefit of reducing wildfire fuels on the forest floor, prescribed fire also slows the growth or eliminates underbrush and hardwoods that can encroach on high-value timber plantations.
We have a really robust timber program here at Savannah River, and the main species being grown are loblolly pine and longleaf pine. Here in the southeast, this is all one big fire-dependent ecosystem, and both of those are fire-adapted species, and the fire is actually good for those because it reduces hardwood competition and other plant growth that could put pressure on the trees that we're trying to grow.
Prescribed fires are generally low intensity and planned only when fuel, soil, and weather conditions are right. And fire-adapted trees like southern pines have a thick insulating bark that can withstand the heat and intensity of smaller fires on the forest floor. The Forest Service uses prescribed burns to reintroduce fire into what was once a fire-dependent landscape and to help restore a healthier forest at SRS.
So most wildfires have uncontrolled intensity, and that's what can be hazardous for the public and hazardous for our natural resources here on site. We're actually fighting the fire instead of lighting the fires. What makes our fires different than a wildfire is we are able to bring the fire to the ecosystem on our terms, and we're able to come up with a plan versus when we have a wildfire and the fire kind of dictates what we have to do. It's live fire practice. It is a controlled environment that we wouldn't be able to do on a wildfire. You get to get out there and just kind of hit the pause button and actually sit there and watch and look at the fire and discuss, you know, why is it doing this? Why was it 1 foot flame lengths right here, but then it went right over here, and now it's 6 foot flame lengths. So we can have that discussion, whereas on a wildfire, and we really don't have the time to talk about it until after the fact.
During the most productive burn season, when vegetation is dormant, contracted helicopter support is brought in to fly prescribed fire aerial ignitions, which permits the efficient burning of larger areas.
So we have the firefighters on the ground, and then we have the firefighters on the helicopter side of things. They've taken special training to fly in the helicopter and then use the PLDO machine. It's a machine that hangs out the side of the helicopter, and it is full of ping pong balls. And within those ping pong balls, it has a flaky chemical in it. The machine squirts antifreeze into it and then drops out the bottom of the helicopter.
During the fall to the forest floor, a chemical reaction begins that results in the balls combusting after they hit the ground. The safely executed system saves time and money. Prescribed burning is also an important wildlife management tool in the forests at SRS.
So red-cockaded woodpecker, also known as RCW, is a huge management goal here at Savannah Riverside because it's a threatened and endangered species. We're federally mandated to manage for that species. And lucky for us, that species loves fire. So the ecosystem it's looking for is large, old-growth longleaf with a really open understory. So the best way to get an open understory in the southeast is prescribed fire.
The yearly interval between prescribed fires in individual areas on the site is determined by forest management objectives. If conditions are right, burns can be conducted any time of year.
At the end of the day, at the most basic level, we are all firefighters. We're always staffed and ready for an initial attack wildfire, but interspersed between there, we're always planning and we're always doing fire. It's a long game instead of a short game mentality. Over time, those hazardous fuels are reduced. Here at Savannah River, we're really lucky that we have a year-round prescribed fire program.